Hello, welcome. My name is Randy and I am going to talk about getting sponsors. I've been a professional kiteboarder for 5-6 years of my life, and dealing with sponsors and getting sponsors and deciding to quit sponsors is something I've got a lot of experience with. So I wanted to share that with you. And perhaps if you're a nonprofit organization, or if you're an athlete, or a YouTuber, or any other influencer, you might want to get some sponsors or advertisers, or basically anything is the same when it comes to getting sponsors or getting advertisers or getting business. What is it that you do? And who can you help with that? Or who will benefit from the things that you do? When you get a sponsor, never assume it's them helping you. They will never just go out, give you money just to help you, because that will be charity. They will go out and help you because it helps them. They are selfish, and that's just the way it is. So for me, as a kite surfer, for example, I had several sponsors. And most of these sponsors, whenever I tried to talk with them, always tried to sell me on the idea that they are helping me. But being older now and being more aware and know more about the industry, it's never been about them helping me. They would never help me if they don't benefit from this. And the proof lies within the fact that the moment I broke my ligament, most of the sponsors just cut me off, don't pay any money, just for the fact that I cannot be of any use to them for that certain year. Once the year was over, hey, there they were again. And that to me shows that it's about them, it's not about you. And no matter what they're trying to tell you, no matter what they're trying to say, as young aspiring athletes, especially when you're 16, 17, 18 years old, you're not as strong with words or mentally or believe in yourself enough that you bring that much value to them. So it's very easy to get ripped off, and they will say, hey, you know, if there's a clothing sponsor, they will say, hey, here, we give you 20 shirts, and you put a sticker on your board, you put a sticker in your video, you create content for us. And you shouldn't agree with this. And I know there's always the feeling that when you're too small, there's the feeling, there's this feeling that you shouldn't, if I don't do it, someone else will get it. And that's 100% true, but realize who you are. And if you are just starting out within the industry, perhaps for the first year, it's a good deal to get some clothes, get some stuff, let them help build your image while you help build their image. It's a win-win and it's a fair situation. But the moment you grow, the moment you start to compete on a larger level, or the moment you have more followers on YouTube, they have to grow with you in the things that they are giving you. Okay, I'm kind of rambling here now because I wanted to start with how to recruit the sponsors, because that's the first step. Being self-aware and knowing who you are is the first step. Like, if you're a world champion, people will come to you, and they will come to you nonstop. If you've got 50,000 followers on your YouTube channel, people will come to you nonstop. If you are a nonprofit organization that does a lot of good, creates a lot of content, has a community with a lot of followers, people will come to you. But when you are starting out, you are small and you're just beginning, you will have to go to them. You'll have to work to get the exposure to show why you're different. So here's what I did when I started out looking for my first sponsor. I went to Brazil and I invested some money of my own. There I got some photos. They were not high quality photos like I would later on in life get, but they were good enough. And I wrote a whole, like almost an essay, like a little book presenting myself, my name, what I did before, who I am, what my ambitions are. And then I got to the most important part, what I can bring to them, what I believe would be of value to them. Because the only thing they care about is the value you bring to them. And mostly they will be aware of it. And if they're a really good brand, they will brand you and work on building your image. However, that said, with all my sponsors that I've had, I think they did a really, really poor job on branding the athletes that they've actually got. and they were way too worried about branding their own brand. But I think that once they decide to sponsor people, these athletes are their brand. And these athletes are content creators that create content nonstop to build up an image for their brand. And I think that most of my sponsors failed a huge opportunity there. But show that to them. Like, if you truly believe that, show it to them and show them why it's that important. Then within this book, I sent this book to people that I personally met, because otherwise it would just end up on the trash mostly. Or I would contact them. I would call them by phone and I would ask them if I could send them a little report. And don't aim too high yet. If you're small, don't aim for a sponsor like Red Bull. Don't aim for a sponsor like Canon. I know it's the dream. I know it's what you would like to do. But there's so many people out there within your industry that are bigger than you that would be much more likely to get that job. So focus first on the small places. Like, which companies that are not that big yet, that are up and rising, up and coming, would benefit more and are willing to invest a little bit. Look, if you can sell out a little bit of space within your videos, if you can sell out a little bit of space on your kite surfboard or on your t-shirts or on your motorbike or on your car, this can already be of value to them. And if you can provide them with content, it's not only putting the sticker and done. Being an athlete or being a sponsored person, you will need to bring value to them nonstop. If you are sponsored by BIC, the pen company, just having their logos on your website wouldn't be enough. Every time you go out and write or you're here on this show, there's a pen on the table and that's a pen of BIC. Or there's a little basket standing over here, which is showing the logo of BIC with a box of pens. So I will help them build their image and create content that is valuable to them. So I was sponsored by GoFast, an action sport brand. And I made this really, really cool picture. They didn't ask me to do it. And in the end, the lighting sucked because the photographer was just a hobby photographer. And we worked for about an hour or two to get this picture, perfect. And the thing is, they never really used this picture much. And I understand because the lighting wasn't good. But they did use it on their social medias. They did use it in a magazine full print, which I created. I was writing columns for a kitesurfing magazine. I just went to the kitesurfing magazine. I said, hey, I'm one of the most famous kitesurfers in Holland. Let me write a column each month for each issue. And in return, I want you to post my travel reports. I want you to post my pictures and all these things. I do something for them, I create value for them. And in return, I give them something else, which is also of value to them, but probably as much value to them as it is to me. So these are some ideas and some tricks that you can work with. And what I would advise if you're really young, get a manager. Get somebody to speak up for you, somebody you believe in. Somebody who actually pitches your ideas first to you, because I got a manager once, and I think his name was Toon van Haren, I'm pretty sure. And he had this website called extremesports.nl, and I think he was a designer because he designed some pretty good stuff, like that looked really nice. I'm just not sure if he did it or not, but he was full of shit. Like, I would never vouch for this person. I would warn everybody not to go in business with this guy. Why? Because he only talked bullshit and he never executed anything. We were going to the ISPO and he was supposed to make this huge portfolio of the things we did and the business plan and everything. And he kept on lying to us. And we just saw that. And after, I think, 3 months, 4 months, I was fed up with the lies and decided, okay, I'm done here. And I just cut him off and called out his bullshit. And then my other two friends who were with the same manager also stopped working with him. So watch out before you get a manager. That's the message I kind of want to say. I don't want to, maybe now he changed, you know, like maybe now he's a better guy and I'm giving him some negative reviews, which is not my intent. The only intent is that this is my experience with the guy and with a manager. So not all managers are great. Make sure that the manager you get executes on the things he's doing, and don't make any deal before he proves himself and before you like whatever it is that he's doing. So yeah, a lot of rambling going on, and I hope you liked it. I hope this is of any value to you. Leave a comment down below. If you have any follow-up questions, or if you want to get some specific examples of the things you should do within the industry you're in, just ask below and I will answer them for you, either in the comments or I'll make a video about it, especially for you. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.